Good day, everyone. You are welcome to Love With. I'm Elizabeth Ifeadetonu. We are still on the series of Who is a Foolish Virgin? And this is the sixth series. This is the sixth episode, I mean. So if you have missed the first, the second, third, fourth, fifth episode, you might have to go up there, listen to them so that you can flow with what we are saying. And I believe, of course, you will surely be blessed. So today, again, our topic is Who is a Foolish Virgin? Who is a foolish virgin? Remember, in each episode, I usually tell you that this characteristics is not limited or is not restricted to whether a male or female gender. I'm addressing the two genders. So whatever pronoun I used, she or he, just know that it goes to both gender. Who is a foolish virgin? The next point. This is our sixth point now. A foolish virgin is someone that got engaged to someone they have only met online. Ha! Things are happening. What you take marriage for? Honestly, I don't know. It's only God and you that know. How will a sane man get engaged to someone you have only met online? You don't know them beyond online, and you get engaged to them. How foolish can you be? Let me tell you, many people will tell you, my husband of 5 years, my husband of 2 years, we met online, and the day we do introduction is the day we first get to see each other, and we did it, our introduction, God took all the glory, we did wedding, we are bouncing, we have 3 kids already, we have 10 kids already. Kudos to them. But let me tell you one thing. Number one, if the word is your standard, worldly now, WORLD, is your standard, and you claim to be a child of God, there will be a problem. There are many things these people that they see as normal thing in their life. They see as normal in the journey of marriage. They see as normal in the journey. You do not want that to happen to you. Still, you want to do it their way. If you do your things in the way of the foolish, you will receive a foolish result. No wise man can get the answer of a foolish man. If a wise man is doing his thing in a wise way, in a wise manner, the end result will be wise. The result that follows being wise is what will come to him. If you do it in a foolish manner, the result of being foolish, it's what comes. You can't swap it. You can't act foolishly and get the opposite. You can't act wisely and get the opposite. See, if you try to do your things in the way worldly people would do it, if you have their result, you will not be okay. At least some people believe that all men are cheats. There is no man that doesn't cheat, and if your man cheats, just package yourself and move on. It's normal. Which is not normal. So somebody that believes that can act anyhow, can do anything. You do not believe in that. You do not want it. Then you must not act anyhow. And let me tell you, good principle will always work 100%. If you see 100 people go against the principle, go against the right thing, you can see, of course, 2 of them coming out eventually to boast of how successful that thing is. Of course, you will see few people like that. Then the 98 or 95% will, of course, fail woefully, and they will be biting their tongue. But if 100% apply, 100 people apply a good principle, it will always work. It will work for the 100. That is it. So that someone is saying, we met online. In fact, we did our introduction online. And you are thinking, okay, I can be good too. It will not be funny. How on earth will you met someone online. They propose to you on WhatsApp. Hello, you chat for a week. I love you. I like you. What is your name? Where do you live? And all of that. They propose, I would like to. Then you receive the proposal. After that, you caught online. You visit them probably once or twice. Of course, somebody you visit once or twice. How will you know them beyond online? Then when you get married to them, there will be trouble. Because you don't know this person. You don't know him. You don't know her beyond online. So you should expect anything. Before you start to say there are people that get to see each other every day and their marriage do not work, if they do not do what they are supposed to do, even when they are seeing every day, of course it will not work. But that does not mean that you now should not even do your part at all. You get engaged online. You see each other probably once or twice. I had a case of a woman. She said the husband is nowhere to be found, he's drinking, he borrowed money from everywhere in the neighborhood and run away and all of that. And you see, I'm a pastor's daughter. And I was like, okay, your courtship, what was it like? So they see each other. Probably they court for a year. And in a year, they saw each other twice. She said, I went to visit once, he came to visit once, and I even go to see his spiritual father and everything, and we got married. Now, there is trouble. Will that one come to tell you what she's going through, what she's facing? I'm not trying to mock her. I'm only trying to let you know that to have the desired result, you must be able to pay the price. You must be able to do the right thing. And one of them is getting to know who you want to get engaged to beyond online. I believe you have been blessed. See you in the next episode of Who is a Foolish Virgin. Thank you. God bless you.